For most of us, getting close to dinosaurs is only possible at a museum or at the movies. The paleontologist who inspired the character of Dr. Alan Grant in Jurassic Park wants to turn fiction into reality.
Since we couldn't, you know, get DNA from a dinosaur to make a dinosaur, the idea really is to try to make something as close to a dinosaur as possible, using a live animal. And the birds are dinosaurs, so the easiest thing we can do is take a bird and give it a long tail and give it arms and hands rather than wings, right? And go back to having those ancestral characteristics. It shows that evolution worked. I think if we're lucky, it would cost somewhere, I think we could make one for $1 million.
So how much have we learned about dinosaurs since the first Jurassic Park hit our screens?
A lot. We've learned that dinosaurs were feathered. We've learned a lot about dinosaur behaviors. We've learned, you know, that there's a difference in how juveniles look and adults look. We've just learned so much. The movie would, you know, the Jurassic Park 4 will look very different than Jurassic Park 3.
As an advisor on the films, even Jack was enthralled when he first saw the prehistoric creatures he loves so much brought to life.
I thought it was extraordinary. But until it's edited, until it actually is sewn together, there's no way to tell what it's actually going to look like. Mm. So, you know, when it's first screened, and you're like, wow, you know, I thought it was just extraordinary.